आई एम डॉक्टर जेसी जोन, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ एनाटॉमी, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर, एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस जेनेटिक्स। हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया, नमस्ते। एंड जेनेटिक्स, यू नो इट इज अ वेरी असेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ आवर ऑल द मैकेनिज्म दैट हैपेंड इन आवर बॉडी, एंड वी विल सी द जेनेटिक्स इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ द कैरेक्टर्स from one generation to next generation, and it is called the inheritance or the heredity. So it is the most important features of the the characteristic of the animal, how a peculiar characteristic will goes to the other generation, and it will be carried by the genes, and all the things that we will study in this particular manner that will come in the genetics. There are so many branches of the genetics. We will see the cytogenetics, molecular genetics, and biochemical genetics, cancer genetics, and immunogenetics, and developmental genetics, and behavioral genetics, and population genetics. So what is the name? And it will give a clue how we will, what we will study in this particular branches. Cytogenetics, we will study the cellular level. Molecular genetics, we will study the all the genetics at the molecular level, as biochemical, cancer, immunogenetics, and developmental behavior population. So in this manner we will study the all the particular things in the special branch of the genetics. Now what is the importance of the genetics in the medicine? We will see the 50% of the first trimester abortion are due to chromosomal abnormality. So if there is the abnormalities in the chromosomes, and so there is a increase incidence of the abortion, and that will happen in the first trimester. And we will see there some congenital malformation. It means that some abnormalities found in fetal situations, or we will see the afterbirth in the fetus, infants. So the 2-3% of the newborns will contain the congenital malformation due to some abnormalities in the chromosomes, and 2% infants are born with single gene order. So what is the single gene or disorder? It means a single gene disorder happen in the chromosome, so that there's some kind of the peculiar disease will happen, and that will born with that 2% infants. More than half of the childhood blindness, deafness, and mental retardation are due to the genetic disorder. So whatever happened in the genes, and in any problems, in any abnormality in their location, in the gene transfer, mutation, so all these kind of complication will come in the generation, and so that will call the genetic disorders. Now we will see the some peculiar definition of that is the basis of the genetics. We will see gene is the basic units of the genetics. And what is the genome? It is the collection of the genetic information. And we will see the storage unit of the genes that we will call the chromosomes, where the, all the genes will arrange in a particular manner. And DNA is nuclei acid that contain the genetic instructions specifying the biological developmental of all cellular forms of the life. So that is the DNA, that is, there is the, all the basic information of the any development of all cellular forms in particular body for the life. Now we will see the chromosome logical structure. First we will see the what is the locus. The locus is the location of the gene or the marker. We will see gene also marker on the chromosome. If there is, if we have studied that, we came to know that the chromosome is the thing where the all the genes are arranged in a particular manner. So locus is the location of the particular gene that is situated on the particular chromosome. Now we see the allele, one variant form of a gene at a particular locus. So one variant form of the particular gene and particular locus, that is called allele. So we can see there is in this picture there is gene first and gene second, and we can see the locus first, there is the possible allele, that is the A1A2, and the second locus where we can see the possible alleles are the B1, B2, and B3. Now we will see the human genome. Most human cells contain 46 chromosomes. If there are more or less the chromosomes, so there we can see many disease or the many congenital disease will happen, and we will see all these the genetic disorders. So there are the two sex chromosomes in the 46 chromosomes. These are the XY, and we will see these sex chromosomes are XY in the males, and these sex chromosomes are the females will be double X. And there are 22 pairs of the chromosome, then that we will autosomes. And one is the one pair is the sex chromosome, so that is very different from the male to female. And 22 pairs that are the autosomes that will seen in the male and female. Now we will differentiate what is the genotypes and the phenotype at each locus. And except for the sex chromosomes, there are two genes, and these constitute the individual's genotype at the locus. So each locus, and there are placed two genes, and these genes will constitute the genotype of the particular locus. So what expression of the genotype is the term phenotype, and that is, for example, hair color, weight, or presence or absence of the disease. So genotype, there is a particular location of the special genes, and we will see the expression of this particular location arrangement of the gene at the locus, and this will express in phenotype. So we will see the hair color, weight, or anything else, or the some disease. Now we will see some example of the genotype phenotypes, and genotype you can see a particular location of the gene. So where we see alleles, that's EB and EB, and then we see EB, EW, and we can see where is EW only, EB only. So there are phenotype how these expressed in the phenotype. Then we can see there are the creature having the black eyes, and the creature that is having the white eyes and black eyes also. So EB means dominant allele, and EW means recessive allele. So how a gene will come with dominant and recessive allele, and that will also express in the phenotypes. Now we'll see the dominant versus recessive. A dominant allele is expressed even if it is paired with a recessive allele, and recessive allele is only visible when paired with another recessive allele. Dominant allele is expressed, and the phenotype will express if dominant and dominant and dominant and recessive, then will express. And this allele only if it is along with the dominant, then it will not express, but it will along with some another recessive allele, then it will express. So you can see this picture and you can understand how the dominant and recessive allele is seen in a phenotype. Now we will see Mendel's first law. So what is the Mendel's first law? Two members of gene pair segregate from each other into the gametes. So half the gametes carry one member of the pair, and the other half carry the other members of the pair. So two members of the gene pair, so there is one pair, if so there will be a, if there is pair, there will be two members, and they will each segregate from each other into the gametes, and half of the gametes carry the one member of the pair, and other half carry the other members of the pair. So all the information will take the one member, and the some will and the other half will take the other information of the other member. So we can see in this picture. So there are gamete production YY and there is recessive YY and so we will see the all Y will locate and some how they will across to each other how they will product. Mendel's second law means the different gene pairs are sorted independently in gamete formation. So this law says this law is true only in some cases. And gene pairs on separate chromosomes are sorted independently at meiosis. So we can see here in gamete formation so the gene pairs on separate chromosome are sorted independently at meiosis. So in meiosis we will see that pairs will come from the another member. So they it is very essential for the characteristic of some particular body to the another generation. Now we will see the DNA. In 1953, James Watson, Francis Crick and Rosalind Franklin and Maurice Wilkins they discovered the DNA and they lead to understanding of the mutation and relationship between DNA and proteins at a molecular level and their a central dogma happened in 1959. So DNA and RNA and the protein order on the DNA RNA have seen in the central dogma. Now we'll see the genetic concepts of chromosomes. Chromosomes, they are double stranded DNA molecules packaged by histone and scaffold proteins. And chromosomes numbers that is very constant from an organism. If human beings, there is the 23 pair of the chromosome or the 46 chromosomes, so it is very constant for every human beings. So it is the very constant for every creature. And we will see the N, we will use the haploid number and we will use the 2N for the diploid number. So genetic concepts, we can see all the genes in like structure. Chromosomal numbers, each individual inherits 23 chromosomes from father and 23 chromosomes from mother. So how they will get their total 46 chromosomes. So human has the diploid 46 chromosomes and there is 23 from the paternal and there is 23 from maternal. Each maternal and paternal pair represent homologous chromosomes, that is called homologous. So these are genetic forms, how they will seem in genetic, and we can see the how diploid chromosome will seem in this picture and how the haploid we can see in this picture. Now we'll see the genetic concepts. Homologous chromosomes, they will share centromere positions and they will share overall size and they will contain identical gene sets and matching positions. Gene is the sequence of the DNA which is transcribed into RNA and we will see there are types of the RNA, small r RNA and small d RNA or mRNA. Locus is the position on the chromosome of a particular DNA sequence and we have already discussed. DNA is mutable. A variation in the DNA sequence at the locus is called an allele. And diploid organisms contain two allele of each locus. Allele can be identical, that is the homozygous. And if you can be different here, then we will see heterozygous. And if only one allele is present, then we will see the hemizygous. So we can see the all the allele here, how it is present here, and we can see in this picture very clear. Now we will see the genome. It is the collection of the all genetic material of an organism, that is the genome. And genotype, it is set of the allele that present in the genome of an organism. And what is the phenotype? It is the result of gene expression. and the genes are transcribed into RNA. mRNA is also translated into protein, tRNA, rRNA work in translation process, and biochemical properties of the proteins, that is the tRNA, RNA, determine physical characteristics of the organism. So how the gene expression? So the mutation and phenotypic variation we can see at the molecular level. And the cellular level pigment molecule. Medical genetics, when studying rare disorders, six general patterns of the inheritance are observed. So we can see autosomal recessive here, and autosomal dominant and X-linked recessive, and X-linked dominant and condominant and mitochondrial disorders. So we will see and we will study in next video.